Netflix.
To my puppy breath! Artichokes! Papua New Guinea!
Malfunction. Malfunction.
What? Why's
malfunction.
My phone not working? Marzipan! Terrarium! Paleontologist! Huh? That's not a paleontologist! What? Did someone spill a pomegranate smoothie on my keys? No! That's a whopper of a question! Give me the best answer team you got! Pronto! No! I didn't order a pizza! Bah! My system's been smoothied! Huh?
Answer team 341B, reporting for duty, sir! Well, most of us.
Where, Beep and Boop?
I blame the smoothie! Who in the world would cause this calamity? Bang! Is that a pomegranate smoothie? We got a doozy of a question!
Hi, StoryBots!
Hi!
Hey, hi, hi,
you
hi there!
My name is Elena, and I wanted to know, how do you go to space?
Oh, I love space! I know where to find the answer!
Pomegranates have antioxidants that...
Oh, my goodness!
Where'd Bang go?
The smoothie's loose!
We'll have to find Bang later! We gotta get an answer for Elena!
Outer World, here we come!
Pizza delivery!
I didn't order a pizza.
Hey. Where are we?
Oh, it looks like we're on the launch pad!
Launch pad? What's launching?
That!
Wow! That's a big rocket! How much do you think that thing weighs?
Over 2 million pounds, actually, depending on what's inside me.
Whoa!
I can carry people, satellites, space stations, shuttles, rovers, rocks, rigs, rugs, bugs,
rocket,
bags...
Rocket! Excuse me! You're talking super fast!
Well, I am a rocket. I go fast. That's what I do. This be good for you?
Yeah, that's a little better.
Cool. Anyway, hi, Bo and Bing. What brings you to my pad?
We need to answer a question for a kid named Elena.
Go ahead. Shoot. Sky's the limit.
Can you tell us how to get to space if you're not too busy?
I'm happy to help. I'm actually on my launch break. Sorry, just a little rocket humor.
Rocket humor! It's so uplifting!
Okay, let me break it down for you. Rockets are made of 4 major systems. The first is the structural system, which is my nose cone, body, and fins.
Yeah, okay, but where do the people sit?
That's in the payload system, which is the stuff I carry in my nose cone.
You have people in your nose? What happens if you sneeze?
Not that kind of nose, Bing. Then there's the guidance system, which tells me where to go. And the propulsion system? That's my fueling engine.
Wow! But, question. How do you actually get to space?
Well, to launch me and get me into space, you gotta use the fuel inside of me to create thrust.
Thrust? That sounds really familiar.
Thrust, drag, weight, and lift. Thrust, drag, weight, and lift.
Huh.
So, a force is a push or pull on an object. To understand forces, I want you to imagine for a moment that you're standing on a skateboard holding a balloon.
No need to imagine.
Wow, that was fast. Respect. Okay, if you let the air out of the back of the balloon, see how it moves you and the skateboard forward?
Woo, bananas!
Awesome!
Now let's say the balloon is facing up like a rocket. The air leaves from the bottom. This creates the thrust, which pushes the balloon up towards the sky. But unlike a balloon, instead of air, I'm filled with fuel and oxidizer. When they burn in my engine, they make an exhaust that leaves from the bottom. This creates the thrust, which pushes the rocket up off the ground and towards the sky.
You mean all the way into space?
Yes. And once I'm past Earth's atmosphere and in space, I can reach speeds of 17,500 miles per hour.
Wow.
Well, I can run that fast. Was that 17,500 miles per hour?
No. But why don't you come in my nose cone and see what it's like to be inside a rocket?
Ew, I'm not going in your nose.
It's not a real nose, Bing.
Are you gonna take us up to space?
Oh, no. You'd have to go through a lot of training first.
Oh, I wonder what training's like.
Yeah, and I kind of wonder where Bang is.
Whoa, space training manual? Step one, ride the high-G centrifuge to train for blast-off. Okay, this isn't too bad. I can totally handle this. Does anybody have a spatula? Step two, climb a mountain to get in shape. Ooh, anyone have an extra jacket or scarf? How about a thick napkin? Exercise. Step three, learn to drive the rocket simulator. So, we're going to pretend space? Step four, fly a jet at maximum speed. Hey, you guys got any peanuts? A little warning next time you turn, dude. Final step, look cool walking in slow motion.
What it's like to be inside a rocket's nose.
It's so amazing!
Hi, Bo and Bing! Welcome to the capsule! Please keep your hands, arms, and legs inside and remain seated at all times.
Whoa! What do all these buttons do?
Oh no! Don't touch the buttons! That's only for anyone actually going to space. Speaking of, I'd like to introduce you to four very special space travelers. Jared, Haley, Chris, and Dr. Cyan.
Hey, how are you?
Hi, StoryBots.
Oh my goodness! Real space travelers? Hello? Hello there!
Hi, space travelers. Nice to meet you.
It's really nice to meet you. The four of us are going to space, and I'm commanding the mission called Inspiration 4, and we aim to inspire the next generation of space travelers.
And we'll be flying in a rocket similar to the one we're in now.
We'll be orbiting the Earth for 3 days before we come back down.
But before we do, we have to make sure we get all our training in.
Oh, hey, Bo, Bing, what's shaking? It's been an adventure.
Where were you?
I was training too, and I'm like totally ready to go to space.
Bo, Bing, Bang! I've got more questions about space than I know what to do with! You gotta help!
No worries, boss man. I know everything there is to know about space travel now.
I don't know, Bang. Maybe we should let the real space travelers answer.
I don't care who does it. Just give me an answer to this question. Pronto, capiche?
Hi, StoryBots. My name's Minty.
Hey, oh, Minty. How you doing?
Hey, how's it going?
How do you eat and drink in space?
Oh, that's easy.
Yeah, I'll handle that, Bang. When we're in space, we eat a lot of the same foods that we do here on Earth. But when you want that delicious cookie, the issue is it breaks into crumbs that can get all over the place. So instead of the cookie, we have the tortilla. We can put all kinds of good stuff in here, wrap it up, and then when we bite into it, it doesn't make crumbs. So this works in space.
Awesome!
Okay, quick! Here's another!
Hi, StoryBots. My name is Jasmine.
Hello!
Jasmine, good to see you.
Nice to meet you. Jasmine's my favorite flower.
How do you poop in space?
How do you poop in space? Well, the answer is very carefully.
Yeah.
Because everything floats in space, so we have a very special bathroom that has a suction. So everything is safe and clean.
Thank you.
Next question.
Hi, StoryBots. My name is King.
Hey, King. How you doing?
I want to know how you go sleep in space.
Great question. We sleep in space a lot like you would on a camping trip. We use sleeping bags that we tie down to our chairs or Velcro against the wall so that we don't bump into each other in the middle of the night and wake each other up.
Thank you, space travelers.
You answered them all. Thanks, space travelers.
Thank you so much! All
right!
Hey,
well,
thanks, space travelers! That was cool!
Bye! Bye, StoryBots! Thank you!
Well, we learned how rockets work for Elena!
And the Inspiration 4 team was awesome!
And I am, like, totally inspired! I want to go to space, too! I learned so much from the team, like pressing buttons and turning on the lights and reaching headquarters and launching rockets and landing...
Well, you did turn on some lights!
and loud sirens.
Oh no, that doesn't sound very good.
10 seconds to launch. 10 seconds to launch.
Launch? Oh dear, I'm not ready. I'm not ready.
Oh, don't worry, Bo. I totally got this.
Launching.
Living inside computer parts.
The StoryBots.
Helping kids get super smart.
They love to learn.
They love to learn.
And adore adventure.
And answering questions is their business and pleasure. There's a whole department whose only task is to answer anything we ask. So let's see if Team 341B can solve another mystery. The StoryBots. Meet Beep and Bing Bang Boop and Bo. Just ask them what you wanna know. Just ask the StoryBots.